When last we left John Cena owner mode, John had been ruthlessly attacked in the parking lot of Raymond James Stadium by Ryback and by Mr. McMahon. What does Vince McMahon have against John Cena owning an NFL team anyway? It's in his off time here. This isn't interfering with his WWE duties and responsibilities. We're going to have to save that answer for another time and figure out what exactly is wrong with Vince McMahon. But right now, John Cena's recovered from his injuries, and it is back to the preseason here in the NFL. It is cut day again, and he's kind of laboring over the choices here. We're not to the final cuts by any means, so these shouldn't be too hard. He's going to ax Dan Orlovsky, the fourth string quarterback, excuse me. Danny Noble is going to be cut number two here. Andrew Economus, what a name, huh? Yeah, he's got to go, though. It's best for the economy of the Tampa Bay Bucks to cut him loose. Jason Weaver's going to go, and we've got one more, and it's going to be Danny Gore. So there are the five cuts for this week. We are going to try to fly through the preseason here. Cena trying to bond with his players. You see Nix, and you see his quarterback, Freeman, playing some cards, hanging out here. And now it's time for the team to hit that practice field and just trying to work things out, get fine-tuned through this preseason so they'll be ready to go for week one in New York against the Jets. So you see Vincent Jackson making a catch for first down yardage there. Freeman just trying to get his rhythm down, hitting Stalker, the tight end right there. And, of course, they want to get Doug Martin going as well. Had a great rookie season, and he does not want to have a sophomore slump. So we're going to advance through a lot of this preseason here. And hold up a second. That's WWE World Heavyweight Champion Alberto Del Rio. What is he doing at Cena's office here at Raymond James Stadium? What possible business could Del Rio have with Cena anyway? Del Rio's not a football fan, is he? I don't know. We're going to have to find out what that's all about at a later time here. But it is time to sim forward through some preseason here. As you see, they were 1-1 going into that third game. Time to upgrade some players here. I like to do these manually when possible. That way your players will progress in the manner you want them to in the categories that are important to building your team. And so here we go into the last day of cuts. Got to cut down to the 53-man roster, the final roster. So Cena and Coach Greg Schiano going over those cuts meticulously, trying to make sure they get this right here. They want to make sure they don't axe anybody that will come back to haunt them here. So it's still pretty cut and dried. We're not making any real big surprises here. We're also going to import our draft class from NCAA 14 so that we get some real players to go scout. That's going to make this much more fun. Now, we saw something on the waiver wire that we were interested in. We are going to send David Douglas packing. That was a tough move because, of course, you're dealing with a player's life right here, and Douglas will come in and plead his case to stay on this Tampa Bay Bucks roster. But to take a page from Triple H, John Cena needs to do what is best for business right here. And he's got to make this move because he's found someone that he thinks can really contribute and be an upgrade at the wide receiver position here. So Douglas is sent packing. He eventually accepts that decision. What other choice does he have? And Aldrick Robinson will be coming in at the age of 24 and a 78 overall. That is an upgrade to our wide receiving core for the price we're paying for him there. So definitely meeting with the media now afterwards, talking about the final roster moves and the excitement going into week one. Schiano is taking questions. Cena is taking questions. But it is just about time for all this to get underway as far as the regular season. So Cena gets in his limo, headed to the airport, and headed to New York City. As well, actually, headed to the Meadowlands, if you want to be technical. But they're going to be taking on the New York Jets in week one. So we're finally getting underway with games that count. So we're going to be at MetLife Stadium here in week one. Familiar place for John Cena? Yeah, that's where he won the main event in WrestleMania 29 right here in MetLife Stadium. He beat The Rock to win the WWE Championship once again. And that is definitely a fond memory for John Cena. Now, he's already lost that title, of course, and he's gone on to get his surgery and, get into the football business. So now he'll be back to MetLife Stadium, but this time in the owner's capacity of the Tampa Bay Buccaneers, watching his team take on the New York Jets. So you see Geno Smith He'll be making his first ever NFL start here in week one against the Bucs, so the teams are ready for the coin flip. And here we go. The Jets get the ball first, and Geno Smith comes out throwing. Santonio Holmes is the target for his first ever NFL completion, and now he's throwing to Holmes again on the left side. Another first down. Okay, the rookie might be getting some rhythm here that'll help him ease into this ball game. Shotgun snap again, and over the middle. This time it is Hill making the catch. It is another first down, the result the same. Smith is going to find Santonio again the third time here on this opening drive. And the Bucs are having a hard time stopping this. Winslow will make the catch over the middle. He gets absolutely blown up, but he does make the catch. And here is Goodson getting into the end zone. So the first score goes to the Jets today in front of their home crowd. And dance, buddy, dance. There you go. Goodson is fired up. He's in the end zone. The crowd is as well. 7-0 lead for the Jets. You see Rex Ryan is happy. Indeed, there on the sideline as Mike Goodson punched it in. But now it is Josh Freeman's turn to come out and lead his offense here. We should be pretty high-powered offensively if Josh Freeman can orchestrate everything here. You see him hit Luke Stalker for the first down there. The tight end gets it done. So Freeman drops back and again is looking. This time he'll find his man Vincent Jackson spinning and getting himself a first down and more. First and 10, handoff to Doug Martin. Here he goes straight forward. He's spinning around and to the ground. He gets a gain of 6. Second and 4. And we've got a counterplay for Martin that'll get him a first down. Okay, our first drive is going well as well. Let's keep it going. Second and 4. Play action. And the game stutters a little bit. But Freeman, well, he stutters a little bit too. And he gets hit and loses the ball. Pace picks it up. He is going all the way back to the end zone. No one's even in the picture here to give him a run for it. Touchdown, New York Jets. The defense scores. And it's now 14-0. Freeman, oh, he got caught being indecisive there. He had a man open in the flat had he thrown it early enough. But instead, he pays the price. He fumbles, and they take it all the way back for the touchdown. All of a sudden, the Jets have a 14-0 lead, and the first quarter isn't out yet. Freeman, yeah, everything got out of rhythm here after that turnover and touchdown. But look at this. Geno Smith doesn't really get anything going on his side either. We're into the second quarter now. Freeman's got the ball back. And what is he going to do on third and long? Well, he almost throws a pick. So again, just everything out of rhythm. I think Freeman really got rattled by that fumble. Here comes a blitz. Geno Smith is going to take off, but no, he's not getting anywhere. The linebacker Foster records the sack, and the ball goes back to the Buccaneers. Freeman is throwing to Jackson, and they're going to be just short. It's fourth and inches. Vincent Jackson, a nice catch in traffic. They decide to keep the offense out there, and Doug Martin plows forward for that first down and more. So first and 10, the game hiccups a little bit more here. Freeman is going to take off this time, use his legs, and slide down really close to that first down. It'll be second and 1. After the 9-yard gain, that's the element that Freeman is so good at there, is using his legs. So there is a first down for Doug Martin, and Freeman's going to throw again. This time to Martin, but no, he can't hang on third down. He probably would have been short anyway. And they bring on Connor Barth for the field goal attempt. Oh boy, that doesn't work out either. Wide left, and it is an empty trip. It is still 14-0. We do not like the way this is going with 6 minutes left before half. But Geno Smith, we've started to figure this out a little bit. Got a little pressure, and Spence gets the sack. So there's a nice play by the D-line, getting pressure, and Geno Smith gets popped right there. Look at that big hit. Tampa Bay gets the ball back with about 5 minutes to go. And Vincent Jackson, did you see that catch? Well, if you didn't, you'll see it again. He reaches back behind him and makes the one-handed snag. My goodness, that is a veteran NFL wide receiver doing his job right there. And he catches one right here before getting hit hard. He's already got 5 receptions for 71 yards. First and 10, and Freeman over the middle. Doug Martin catches this one this time. He gets hit hard as well. But they will be moving the ball here. Third and 12, and Freeman needs a play. Great pass to Ogletree. Makes the catch and turns up. They have first and goal now after that. Doug Martin will plow forward into the end zone, and Tampa has their first score of the season. Play that air guitar, baby, and swing that axe. Doug Martin is in for the touchdown, his first of the season, and hopefully many, many more for this electric running back here. Yep, we are thrilled to have him on our roster. So Geno Smith wants to answer. He's going deep one-on-one, but you don't test Darrelle Revis like that. He will pick you off more often than not, and he does right there. He blankets Santonio Holmes and gets the interception. So getting a little greedy here. This is not what you want to do if you're the Jets offense, is turn the ball over. Look at that coverage of Darrelle Revis. That's why he's one of the best. Revis Island out there. Freeman, with just seconds left, they're going to heave this for a last chance effort. They were not in field goal range. It is picked off. Yeah, big deal. They just tried to give it a shot there to the end zone, and it didn't work. So halftime right here, 109 passing yards, 67 rushing. Yeah, pretty good. And the time of possession is in our favor as well. But we find ourselves down 14-7. Luke Stocker makes a nice catch and then gets himself dizzy with all those spins. It will be a first down. Hand off to Doug Martin. We've got a counter play. Oh, nice little stutter step there. And he changes the ball to the outside hand as he runs downfield. He is just short of 100 yards now. After that great rush, he gashes the Jets defense on that one, so we'll gladly take that. And it's first and 10. Freeman quickly to Luke Stocker, makes a couple people miss, stays on his feet, and ends up in the end zone. We've got a tie ball game. Freeman hits Stocker. Oh, look at him spike it over the goalpost there. Nice job, and Shiano's happy here. They have tied it up. It looked rough in the beginning, going down 14-0, but Stocker makes the catch. And yes, sir, he is in the end zone. Nice job staying on his feet there, not stumbling to the ground, but instead getting in for the score. So there you go. We're tied at 14, and Luke Stocker's got three big catches already, including that touchdown. So Geno Smith, the pressure on him now. Look out. Pressure literally gets him. It's Spence and his second sack of the day. Nice little dance afterwards. And Geno Smith is starting to take some abuse back there. In the pocket, he might want to get out of there if he can. He's tried a couple times with not much luck. So they will have to punt here, 4th and 15. And this is Doug Martin back to field it. He is going to reverse his field and try to get towards midfield. Oh, he's taken down by a face mask there. That looks like it's going to be the call in 15 yards. They do not need that, do the Jets. And you see Rex Ryan not happy about the outcome there. So they get 15 yards tacked onto the return. Doug Martin running hard for 7 yards, and he's just one short of 100 here in the third quarter. They're going to hand off to the backup, Brian Leonard, who is also capable. He is going to get first and goal here. Martin checks back into the game, and he is going to be in for the touchdown. Just like that, the Bucks are ahead, but hold everything. We've got a booth review. Rex Ryan calls for the challenge. Will he win this one? Let's see. Spun around. Where is the ball? His body's in the end zone, but where is the ball when he touches down at first here? That's going to be a close call. What are they going to say? They are going to come back, and after looking at it, they are going to reverse the call. Martin did not get in, and even worse, Martin was dinged up on the play. Goes to the sideline. Brian Leonard in, spins, and eventually gets across the goal line, so they do get their touchdown. One way or another, Brian Leonard in. He will get credit for it, not Doug Martin. But most importantly, now we go to the sideline and find out what's going on with Doug Martin, and it is not good. The news is broken ribs. He is definitely not coming back in this game, and one has to worry about how long he is going to be out of the lineup with an injury like that. That is a very tough one to take, especially to a star running back like that. Curley is able to help out his quarterback Geno Smith there by catching that wounded duck, but he can't help out his quarterback here as he gets taken under and hurt on the play. Mark Sanchez has to check in. Look out for any butt fumbles coming up, but he does hit Curley. Oh, maybe he'll get some momentum going here. So he's going to hand off to Goodson. No, it's a play action. Sanchez hits his man, but this is going to be close. They're going to measure, and it is just short by a couple chain lengths. And the Jets have a decision. They're going to bring on the kicking team. The field goal attempt is up, and it is good. So they cut the lead to 21-17. Having once been up 14-0, they find themselves still down. And here comes Freeman. A quick pass to Stocker, but he does not hang on. Fourth down, they will have to kick it right back to the Jets. Geno Smith back in the game now, which is good to see for the rookie's health. He's back in, but they're not getting anything. Fourth down, and they got a punt. Freeman gets the ball back. What's he going to do? He's going to take off again. Run, Freeman, run. And Josh slides down and gets the first down. And more importantly, saves his health right there. Freeman quickly to Vincent Jackson, who gets popped. Uh-oh. He's slow to get up. He made a great catch again, but he may be injured. Leonard, who now takes over the running back responsibilities, and you see Vincent Jackson, ooh, just a scare. He will be back. We cannot lose two players of that caliber in one game. This drive stalls, but it is a field goal to make it a 7-point lead once again at 24-17. So Geno Smith into the fourth quarter has to try to work some magic. That was almost picked off. It should have been picked off, but wasn't. They need to punt the ball, and here comes the Brian Leonard show trying to run some clock down in this game. First down right there. He's probably the perfect style runner to try to do what they're doing right here. Stocker makes a catch. Again, stumbling forward. Oh, he's been big here. Four catches for 70 yards. Josh Freeman's over 200 passing now with the touchdown and the meaningless interception. So Freeman looking for more. They're coming at him. They set up a screen, and it's perfect. They sent heat, and they couldn't get to him because the screen was called, and Brian Leonard is in the end zone again, this time on a reception. And the Bucs have finally broken open some breathing room in this game. Rex Ryan, yeah, he's not happy he dialed up a blitz there because he played right into their hands. Great play call by Shiano, and they get it done right here with the screen pass, and Brian Leonard is in as he dives down into the end zone. Great play by the Buccaneers. They can yell out a sigh of relief right there as they're now up 31-17 with 3:15 to play. Game's by no means over, but Josh Freeman has had a nice one here. So Geno Smith trying to rally the troops. Here's Curley going to take a short pass and make a first down run out of it. Third and eight now, and they need to convert here. And it's going to be Goodson out of the backfield makes the catch. And he's got a first down, and all of a sudden they are in Tampa territory. Here comes Smith again, getting some protection, and he finds Hill at the sideline, makes a catch before he's ripped down. First and 10, just outside the 10. Geno Smith, where's he going to go this time? He's got some happy feet. Throw into the end zone, and Curley, are you kidding me? Did you see that catch? My goodness, the diving one-handed catch. And yes, he should be happy with himself as he has pulled the Jets back into a ball game here. Maybe they can get the onside kick, but first, look at that catch. Rings it in one-handed and brings it to the body to secure it as he falls to the field. What an amazing play by Curley. And this game is not over. We've got an onside kick attempt coming up right here. They're going to tee it up, and here it goes. It is covered by Tequan Underwood, and this should be over. At least that'll be the case if we can get one first down and exhaust all their timeouts. So Leonard to the right, yeah, he's going to be piled up there. They'll be 5 yards short, third and five. Do you risk trying to pass here? They try the quick slant, and Underwood, who covered the onside kick, now makes the biggest catch of the game, getting them the first down, and they have iced this. So now it is just a matter of running out the clock, and the Buccaneers win on week one of the NFL season, 31-24. Cena down on the field congratulating his quarterback. That's the first official win there for John Cena in his tenure of owner for the Tampa Bay Bucks. So he comes back to MetLife Stadium and is victorious once again, once in WrestleMania 29, now in week one of the NFL season. What a great feeling. And these Tampa Bay Bucks are off on the right foot. Josh Freeman, 17 of 28, 233 yards. And a 60% completion percentage, the two touchdowns. Nice job right there. Brian Leonard gets 72 yards, mopping up for the injured Doug Martin, who had 105 when he left the ball game. Oh, we're going to have to check the injury report and see just how bad that is for him. Vincent Jackson, six catches for 86 yards, leading the way for the receivers here. Great job for him, and there are the defensive stats as well. So as the fans file out, John Cena makes his way to the press room here to handle the press conference after the game. You see a question coming in here about how they're going to perform better than last season. He is definitely giving his thoughts about that. And of course, he expects a better season and to make the playoffs. That's exactly what he wants to see happen here. But he says, we're going to forget last season. This is a different team. And it's a team that knows we can't miss the playoffs again. So that was his answer. And that's a good answer. So week one is in the books, as that is a 31-24 road victory. You got to love getting any road victory in the NFL. Those are big. And Doug Martin's hurt. They're saying he's going to be set back for a couple of weeks. That's what the media is saying. Okay, so like 2 weeks, we could probably weather that storm. Let's go check out the official word. Give it to us here. Oh my goodness. No, it's not a couple weeks. It's 5 weeks. That's significant. We're going to have to make a move there in free agency, I think, to cover that while he's gone. I mean, Brian Leonard is good, but I mean, we are thin there. And we're looking to see what's out here. Willis McGahee is old. He's a little bit run down, but he's 84 overall, and I think he fits the bill here for a short-term replacement. We're going to go ahead and sign him to a one-year contract. Cena signs off on that, and Willis McGahee will be coming to town to take over until Doug Martin can get back in that lineup, and it sounds like it's going to be a little while. So we're back home to Tampa, and oh, it's Alberto Del Rio again. What is going on? What is with this meeting here between these two? I don't know. Well, hold up a second. That's a briefcase, and that has a lot of money in it. What is Alberto Del Rio doing giving a briefcase of money to John Cena? What does this all mean? My head's about to explode. We got some kind of partnership going on. Come on back next time to find out what this is all about. We'll see you next time on John Cena Owner Mode.